Mary and Joseph.
Mary and Joseph? Is that what you were going to say too, Mel?
Yeah.
This was how Jesus, God's anointed one, was born. His mother Mary had promised Joseph to be his wife, but while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit.
An angel told her.
That's right!
Can I say something?
Angel told her.
During the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, the angel Gabriel was sent from God's presence to an unmarried girl named Mary, living in Nazareth, a village in Galilee. She was engaged to a man named Joseph, a true descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Grace to you, young woman, for the Lord is with you, and so you are anointed with great forever." Mary was deeply troubled over the words of the angel and bewildered over what this may mean for her. But the angel reassured her, saying, "Do not yield to your fear, Mary, for the Lord has found delight in you and has chosen to surprise you with a wonderful gift. You will become pregnant with a baby boy, and you will name him Jesus. He will be supreme and will be known as the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will enthrone him as king on his ancestor David's throne. He will reign as king of Israel forever, and his reign will now have no limit." Mary said, "But how could this happen? I'm still a virgin." Gabriel answered, "The Spirit of holiness will fall upon you, and Almighty God will spread his shadow of power over you in a cloud of glory. This is why the child born to you will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. What's more, your aged aunt Elizabeth has also become pregnant with a son. The barren one is now in her sixth month. Not one promise from God is empty of power, for nothing is impossible with God." Then Mary responded, saying, "This is amazing. I will be a mother for the Lord as his servant. I accept whatever he has for me. May everything you have told me come to pass." And the angel left her.
Oh, I got an answer.
30?
30?
About 30. Back then, it was actually
22.
Estimated. She was a little younger than 30.
22.
She was still a teenager, we're thinking.
18. God. 18.
Right. Around the age of 18. Between 16 and 18. Yeah. Pretty young. What do you think he said? Sophia.
I think he was surprised and he was really happy.
No? Well, actually, Joseph was kind of upset because they weren't married yet.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. They weren't married yet.
Her fiancé, Joseph, was a righteous man full of integrity and didn't want to disgrace her. But when he learned of her pregnancy, he secretly planned to break the engagement. While he was still debating with himself about what to do, he fell asleep and had a supernatural dream. An angel from the Lord appeared to him in clear light and said, "Joseph, descendant of David, don't hesitate to take Mary into your home as your wife, because the power of the Holy Spirit has conceived a child in her womb. She will give birth to a son, and you are to name him Savior, for he is destined to give his life to save his people from their sins." This happened so that what the Lord spoke through his prophet would come true. "Listen, a virgin will be pregnant. She will give birth to a son, and he will be known as Emmanuel, which means in Hebrew, God became one of us." When Joseph awoke from his dream, he did all that the angel of the Lord instructed him to do. He took Mary to be his wife, but they refrained from having sex until she gave birth to her son, whom they named Jesus.
No. It wasn't Minneapolis.
I know what it was.
What was it?
Bethlehem.
Whoa!
That's right!
During those days, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus ordered the first census be taken throughout his empire. Quirinius was the governor of Syria at that time. Everyone had to travel to his or her hometown to complete the mandatory census. So Joseph and his fiancée Mary left Nazareth, a village in Galilee, and journeyed to their hometown in Judea. To the village of Bethlehem, King David's ancient home. They were required to register there since they were both direct descendants of David.
was born?
Rags.
Right when he was born. Did he come out wearing rags? Then after he was born, they wrapped him.
Yes. In rags.
That's right. Yes.
When they arrived in Bethlehem, Mary went into labor, and there she gave birth to her firstborn son. After wrapping the newborn baby in strips of cloth, they laid him in a feeding trough since there was no available space in any upper room in the village.
Think of a baby that's just born. What was his first words?
Gagagoo.
That's right.
He weighed as much as one penny.
He weighed the weight of a penny.
They work all the time.
All the time. Right.
That night, in a field near Bethlehem, there were shepherds watching over their flocks.
That would be a good time of day.
What do you think, Charlie?
Same. Yeah. What sound does a sheep make?
A wolf. Ooh, that would scare me.
That would be scary. What's scared? Some of the time for a second. What's scared to the shepherds?
What would scare you if you were out in the field at night all by yourself?
Was it a wolf? Was it a turtle? Was it a sheep? Or was it one of the turtles?
Was it the turtle? Gosh,
I'm
scared.
The turtles. I agree.
It was action.
It was an angel.
An angel.
Yeah.
The sheep?
The shepherds.
Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared in radiant splendor before them, lighting up the field with the blazing glory of God, and the shepherds were terrified. But the angel reassured them, saying, "Don't be afraid, for I have come to bring you good news, the most joyous news the world has ever heard, and it is for everyone everywhere. For today in Bethlehem, a rescuer was born for you. He is the Lord Yahweh, the Messiah. You shall recognize him by this miracle sign. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a feeding trough."
A song that's like, isn't there a song that like says something about like the 99 and the one sheep?
There is. That would be a really good one.
That would be a good song.
That'd be really meet for the shepherds.
I
forgot
what it was called.
That Jesus still comes out for that one, lost sheep.
That would be a good song.
That would be a perfect song.
Silent Night.
What song was it?
The Little Drummer Boy.
I forgot what you told me.
Or the angel sing.
It was Happy Birthday.
Better to sing.
I'm so glad it's Christmas.
Yeah, it's that song.
Then, all at once, a vast number of glorious angels appeared, the very armies of heaven, and they praised God, singing, "Glory to God in the highest realms of heaven, for there is peace and a good hope given to the sons of men."
Eat some sheep.
No.
Who eat sheep?
I don't know. They're like 99% wolf.
You can't eat wool? No.
No.
You don't think there's any meat under that wool?
It's fur. You can't eat fur. You don't know what type of stuff is in fur.
Yeah, you definitely wouldn't want to eat the fur.
No.
So, no, they didn't go and to dinner with the shepherds after the angels came. Where do you think the angels went?
What?
Where
did the angels go? Where did they go? Where did the angels go? Heaven!
That's right. When the choir of angels disappeared back into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go. Let's hurry and find this word that is born in Bethlehem and see for ourselves what the Lord has revealed to us." So they ran into the village and found their way to Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in a feeding trough. Upon seeing this miraculous sign, the shepherds recounted what had happened. Everyone who heard the shepherd's story was astounded by what they were told.
These men. Oh, do you know what their names were?
No.
You don't know their names? I bet Ethan knows.
Well,
Lulu.
Lulu, yeah. She's a wise man.
Lulu,
for sure.
Was the first wise man.
Yeah.
Yes.
What was another name of one of the other
ones?
Ruby. Lulu and Ruby and.
Daisy.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem near Jerusalem during the reign of King Herod. After Jesus' birth, a group of spiritual priests from the east came to Jerusalem and inquired the people, "Where is this child who is born king of the Jewish people? We observed his star rising in the sky, and we have come to bow down before him in worship."
Like when she's mad. Two fists in the air.
King Herod was shaken to the core when he had heard this. Not only him, but all of Jerusalem was disturbed when they heard this news. So he called a meeting of the Jewish ruling priests and religious scholars, demanding that they tell him where the promised Messiah was prophesied to be born. "He will be born in Bethlehem, and in the land of Judah," they told him.
There's a name of a person, we call this person something, when they're able to tell us something that's going to happen. Do you know what they call them? God. Yeah, God can tell us things. But this, as far as like in the Bible, there were some things that were prophesied.
The prophecy states, "And you, little Bethlehem, are not insignificant among the clans of Judah, for out of you will emerge the shepherd king of my people Israel."
What did King Herod tell the wise men to check on? And then report back to him. Do you know?
No. Jesus.
Right. Jesus. That's correct.
Then Herod secretly summoned the spiritual priests from the east to ascertain the exact time of the exact time the star first appeared. Then he told them, "Now go to Bethlehem and carefully look there for the child, and when you found him, report to me so that I can go and bow down and worship him too."
What shape were they looking for?
We would like you to draw star. That shape on here.
Yeah, draw the shape that they were looking for.
Guys, what do you think it is?
A square?
I don't think it's a square.
I want to know.
Guys, what's up in the sky?
What's it look like? I want to go.
What do they look like?
Draw it on the board. What do you guys think?
Guys, what's up in the sky?
What does it look like?
Guys, what is this? What is this?
A star!
Can you draw a star, Emery?
Very nice. They were looking for a star.
And so they left, and on their way to Bethlehem, suddenly the same star they had seen in the east reappeared. Amazed, they watched it as it went ahead of them and stopped directly over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were so ecstatic they shouted and celebrated it with unstrained joy. When they came into the house and saw the young child with Mary, his mother, they were overcome. Falling to the ground at his feet, they worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure boxes full of gifts and presents for him and presented him with gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Afterward, they returned to their own country by another route because God had warned them in a dream not to go back to Herod.
So, Mary and Joseph brought Jesus in to be dedicated to the temple. Like, my sister was dedicated to the church, and Jesus was dedicated to the temple.
God had promised Simeon that he would make sure that he would meet the Messiah in his lifetime and wouldn't die before the Messiah came.
Then when Mary and Joseph came into the temple carrying baby Jesus, Simeon realized that it was the Messiah, praised the Lord, and blessed them. So when Mary and Joseph carrying baby Jesus went into the temple, Simeon saw them and he knew that it was the Messiah. He came up to them, asked to hold Jesus, and blessed them and prophesied that Jesus was the Messiah, and he would save all of Israel along with the Gentiles.
Mary.